Okay, hope you enjoyed that little piece. I thought I'd just go through a little overview of what was going on there. It's not too complicated in terms of the modular elements. Obviously, got a vocal drum called SQ1 sequencer. Outside the modular setup, I suppose the NTS1 is outside, sort of a VCO and effects, or just on that one, and then we've got the microphone down the bottom. But we'll go through some of the basic sounds. So obviously we've got this microphone set on a super wave setting, which gives you the rich string sound. I was varying the attack and the decay and the filter amount throughout the piece, plus a bit of cutoff and resonance there. I've already adjusted wave temper and shape. That's being fed through this phase shifter here, which is an old-fashioned, like 70s, 80s phase shifter on this Behringer 172, and that is being modulated by this built-in LFO onto this module. So I can control the shift frequency. I need a bit more high frequencies in for you to hear this. And there's the modulation intensity and resonance. So that's the sort of string sounds. Also, at one point, I was using the clock, which is, I'll go through that in a minute, it's been the master clock, is the vocal drum, fed to the arpeggiator. So I switched that on, changed the attack. And we were getting this kind of effect. So I was doing these broken arpeggios, and that was all in sync. So that's a sort of microfeak. The other thing that was happening was this little module, which you possibly not see. It's a 2HP pluck, and that was being triggered by two sequences. The first one was the SQ1 on a random setting, so it was triggering randomly any notes that I had decided to make active in the 16 step sequence. So obviously if there's less notes on, the less chance of them being triggered. And if I just turn the pluck up, and it's so it was providing some bass sounds, and also a bit later it was providing a little sort of high frequency guitar-y type thing. That is being controlled SQ1 also from a clock divider multiplier here. So when I speed up, I think it's clock 2, I can speed up the rate of randomness. So that's slow, 6 times slow, getting faster and faster. And that's being fed through this little CV mixer here. I think it's meant as an audio mixer, but I'm using it as a CV mixer at the moment. And it allows me to have just the NTS1 on this volume control, or CV attenuation type control. And that's fed into this tip-top quantizer. So this is keeping it in a, in this case, a G minor scale, and I can control the octaves of that. So if we just listen just to the NTS1 being clocked here, being fed into the mixer only, and then out to this G minor, so that sounds like this. I'll increase the number of steps. And using the mixer control here, I can actually control the range of the notes. And you can see this changing on this G minor scale. I can also change the range, octave range, on the slider here, which which is the touch slider. Turn it down a sec. Another important modulation to the pluck is this Doppler 118 noise random CV module, and the random slopey CVs actually feeding the decay of the pluck. So I can change the amount of CV going into that to the amount of CV going into that to change the range of the dampening. So that's what this sounds like. Turn it again. So that's obviously very dampened, and if I increase the amount of random CV going in, it goes from obviously that very sustained sound. And if you get the sweet spot, it will go between a sort of sustained sound and a dampened sound to give it some variation. So we've got the random pitch and then the random dampening. Also, to add a little bit of regularity to the pluck sound, I've also got this 182 sequencer feeding its CV into this mixer. So I can actually mix this sort of set sequence alongside the random sequence, and that gives us these what sounds like sort of hammering on guitar sound, because the gate for the pluck is being triggered by the random one, and this is providing sort of notes in between pitch wise but not the gate. So that has the effect when I introduce it of sounding like this. And I can change the clock on the 182 as well, so the hammering can be more or less. I can also have this faster in the sequence, and then the 182 is slower. And I'm varying all these things throughout the piece, so also the notes on this I varied a couple of times. So all of those are just on the pluck, so all of the guitar-y bass type sounds are coming from there. The other key thing, I suppose it's a four-part piece, this. The pluck, the microfeed, the vocal drum, and then the sound coming from this NTS-1 from this keyboard here. But the vocal drum is pretty self-explanatory, in that we have a bass drum on track one. These are all custom sounds, by the way. We've got a sort of tom complementary bass drum, so the two of them sound like that. We've got a hi-hat on three. A bit of sort of industrial background noise on four, which was there in the sort of slow sections just to provide some atmosphere. Five is a very sort of subtle beat to introduce the tempo. It sort of comes in the quieter sections. So a bossa nova type thing. And then on six, a big snare drum. All of these are being fed through this Strymon Blue Sky at the top, which is on a plate setting at the moment. I didn't want the reverb too big, but I think it possibly could have been overpowering in a couple of sections, but I'm monitoring my headphones, so I often think it's sounding big, but when I play it back, it's not that big. Finally, we've got a sound being played from this Keith McMillan Q-Nexus, which is actually in MIDI mode. It can do CV at this side, and I'm waiting on some actual sound modules so I can play it with this. But for the moment, I've been using the NTS-1 just because I've got it here for effects. But So that's actually going through MIDI at the moment, through this little MIDI expander here. MIDI into this, and the QNexus has got this feature, it's called a tilt thing, which gives you pitch bend if you do a bit of wobbling. The sound on the NTS-1 is basically a slow attack, it's a dual waves, it's called duet, it's a dual oscillator type sound. Obviously this is a digital wave type thing. Filter, quite low. I was going to play with the filter, but I just quite like the mellow sound. Also on fast sequences, it's not particularly good at tuning the mono, because this is mono obviously, so a couple of times you'll hear the clicking as it was fighting between which note to play. A bit of chorus on it, and delay. There was no reverb because that's been fed through the Strymon as well. There's also a pitch bend on here, which I can't remember if we used or not. One of the problems with this keyboard is when you do the tilt, it's hard to get back to the original pitch. You have to sort of re-trigger it. So there's some defects. So there's not a lot of the other modules used here. Were the notes. Oh, the clock, sorry. So the clock is coming out of the Volca drum into this Horsetronic multi, or mult, buffered mult, which allows one in, multiple outs. I'm taking one of the three outs, so that's in at the top. One of the three outs is going into the microfeed to provide the synchronicity with the arpeggiator, and the other one is going into this double clock here, which is then providing the two clocks for the 182 and the the two clocks here, one going into the 182 and the other one going into the SQ1. So hopefully that helps explain a little of what you heard, and leave some likes and comments below and tick the bell and all that type of stuff. Bye bye.